Okay, I'm back home. Again, right? I was a little late for my appointment. I forgot. Was doing the video and all that. And the next thing I know, it's 2 o'clock. So I go to my appointment a little late, right? So I got to make another one. Like I said, right? I did that too. Papers over there. But like I said, I do what I can do. We get back to the disability part and the healing part and the what's what, the what's what. And I'm back home. So here's the thing, right? So what did I do? Well, I went to the VA, right? Again. Went to the stages I need to get my new appointment, right? Signed in the kiosk and all that, right? Still had to ride all the way out there, right? Whether I get the gas money or not, it's up to the VA, right? And again, I need the gas money, probably. But whatever. At the same time, right? Then I went to the mall after my appointment time for the next time, right? Again, I ate my chicken tenders and french fries and Sprite. And a few attractive ladies came in, but I sat and mind my business. A dude needed a little bit of money, so I gave him $5 because I had taken $25 from the bank. And the girl gave me five ones. And then I slowly ate my food as normal. Then I walked to the mall, but I had to sit down around the, where the roadhouse used to be, Texas Roadhouse, right? So I sat there for a few minutes, and then I kept walking, after that, right? Finished my walk, and there was a little bit of traffic going into Fort Worth, and that's it. Now I'm back. Well, you're back. Oh, mom. And you know, basically, I'm gonna stay here, watch TV until what? I go to bed, and then that's my routine. And it don't change. Every day, I do my father's business, not my own. Now, if anything's happening around me and I'm blacking out, someone's doing something wrong to me and involving other people. But they can't do that if they're breaking the law themselves. See, that's what I mean, right? That's why all I can do is forgive the incident when it's revealed what they were doing, right? If you're trying to set me up with a woman, I'm looking for a woman, I know a woman has to be 16 to work in the death salon, right? You're the one breaking the law. Yes. Not me. If the girl tells me she's 37, there's no way for me to magically know that. That's why I asked her her age. Now, I also been to several of them before I went to that one. But at that one, like I said, I lost the hour of time. Right? Now, that's what I'm trying to figure out. Why? Am I mad about it? No. Do I think we talked about it? Sure. Whatever the problem was, we discussed it, right? Me and the girl and whoever had the problem with it, right? But I also made it through the salon, went to go see the movie I was trying to see, but was not too late for it. So I went and seen another movie, as per norm, you would do too, if you went into a store that happened to you. All I know for sure, though, is I went in there for a nail salon, and it turned into an hour longer than it was supposed to be with around the girl. And that's all I could tell her, too. If something happened and I did something wrong, like I said, the guy called the cops on me for just going out there the third time. Is he trying to smoke my ass? And the girl had sex with me, and she wasn't supposed to, but did anyway to prove a point to him. And again... He tried to kill me. I healed like Wolverine. And again. Happened 3 times at least. And again, I tipped her $3, but really gave her 5 on the card. For a reason. And whatever happened, okay, whether it was supposed to happen or not, it happened. That's all I know. That's all you know. But again, I'm not mad about it. I got over it. You gotta get over it too. Even if you don't get over it. I'm still a customer trying to do something. And if you make it about me having sex with one of the girls, I'll have sex with one of the girls because it's not a crime in Georgia. It's not a crime unless you make it a crime. That's why I tell you what the age of consent is, and that's the only kind of woman I'm trying to sleep with. You can't do it either. That's called entrapment when you do that. That's called vigilante justice. When you're taking the law into your own hands because you don't want me to have sex with any woman. That ain't your business. That ain't your business. If you want to be gay or something, that ain't my business. If you have a wife, you keep her by treating her right and not interfering with another man's wife. And that's what I was taught. Like Joseph and Potiphar's wife, I don't take Sarah around to fuck her, but I know she's married, right? So I'm trying to help her as just a friend who has to wait a long time for her to do what the hell she's even doing. And sometimes I can't even find her in the store like the last time. And I don't know what's going on, but I feel like I'm being used by her by this time. Wouldn't you? And I don't rape people either. I don't try to seduce her. And if she tries to seduce me, I'll be like Joseph and Potiphar's wife. Right? I'll say, you're married. I respect your marriage. You have the son living with you. Yeah, if the son wasn't living with her. I know that too. I said, if she's what? Divorced with the kids out the house. Because it can be a problem. Like with Valerie Bertinelli, she only had one son with Van Halen. That's just an example still. But I've never been with Valerie Bertinelli. I'm not trying to. But like with, again, movies I watch, right? I learn from them. I really learn from them. Again, like Sleeping with the Enemy and Which one?
The Bodyguard.
The Bodyguard. And I ain't forgot a damn thing. I'm still me, whatever you're doing. I mean, I'm still Shane Lee every day. Uh-oh. Got an alien spying on him while I was having sex with a girlfriend. But the aliens are already here. Damn. Well, this is about Peeping Tom alien. And he tried to sing to him. Right? What you doing, serenade? The lovers scare them half to death. Because they think they're alone. I don't know either. Man, try to get into the window too. Hey, man. That looks like they were trying to have a fun prior time. What the hell you doing in that bedroom now? Uh-oh, they put the bar out. Can't see your boobies. That's a crime unto death. But they nice boobies for what I did see.
That's right.
Yes, sirree, boob. Well, what's your problem, right? Whether I'm dating a woman younger than me or older than me when I'm single. Do I mess with your dating life? No. If someone shot him in the head or something, right? That's crazy. Uh-oh, is he in hell? That's hell. Ain't that what the crazy Christian tell you? You're going to hell for everything you do wrong. Well, what about the law? Maybe if I'm trying to do the right thing.
Right thing.
Not the wrong thing. No. That's up to me.
That's up to you.
What the heck? He's in a green. What's he trying to do? Make a leaf? You need at least two to cover your genitals.
No, you need at least two to cover your genitals.
And the apron can be hung from your waist or your neck. I think they hung it from their waist, don't you?
Fair enough.
But they knew good and evil with, what does it mean to them? Which one?
Which one? And he took a third of them with him, but he left it.
His first estate. And then others did it later on. So there still has to be more than a certain number. But John mentions 144,000 men and women, probably, who are virgins, probably.
Right.
And they, there's a male without the female, the female without the male and the Lord, right?
I know.
So again, are you misinterpreting things? Probably. Yes, I love everybody. For me. He could be me. She could be one of the girlfriends. Right. It's Brock Hampton. That's the artist, right? There's the alien again. What the hell happened? And you... But you're creating two cultures at once, and this is how you're doing it, right? You have on this side those who believe in freedom of speech. You have on this side those who are trying to copyright things and make their first impression on you,
right?
But you also have those in the middle who are having to deal with both and trying to do the same thing,
right? Yes, you do.
But see, you're playing God then, right? You're letting those who you want to use fair use not use it at all,
right?
You're at like, that don't even exist anymore,
right?
All we gotta do is make laws. But the laws also hinder the artist, and then the rappers can no longer do what? Sample. You're gonna remove that from the rappers. This is a sample. That was, what's his name? Rick James.
I ain't seen him in a while, but that looks like Rick James.
Are you wrong to live in Cali if he's been Sid?
I know.
But see. What do I have to do with it when I'm just doing the same thing? I see everybody else do it, and I can do it well, too.
Dude, before we hit the stage, man, we just
listen to Stay by Rihanna.
That's a pretty girl, Rihanna. And again, she show up your house, you ain't gonna tell her no at all. No. But is she supposed to either? I guess not. Right? But she's dating someone else named Chris Brown,
right?
But he hits her. What kind of jerk off hits his girlfriend,
right?
Is she stepping out or something? I know. Does she want to abort a baby or something with him or what? Does she want to break up with him? Right? And he don't want her to go, so he hits her. Because he can't handle his own life, I know, to get her with him, right?
Babylon.
But everyone fitted here is supposed to be here for whichever reason you choose,
right?
For right or wrong, good or evil, we're all making decisions that affect each other, right? I was taught fair use growing up in Georgia,
right?
I know what that means for music, too,
right?
You were taught copyright law. No one can touch your shit,
right?
That's wrong, too. Why? Because the copyright law is not before the articles of what we can do from what we can't do.
Mm-hmm.
You have freedom of speech. That's words. If I have freedom of speech, I can agree with you in what you're saying.
and freely say it with you and back to you.
Right.
As you can say it back to me.
Right.
That's freedom of speech too. You can also can't censor a word because you don't like a word. That's freedom of speech too.
Right.
If I say a word, like, for example, you don't like, say shit, for example, that's an example, and you don't like it, and you tell me I'm going to hell for it, I'm going to ask you, well, why? It's just the word. It means going to the bathroom. You're the one offended by the spelling and sound of the word, not me. You're trying to censor me. Because you're playing God and Satan to me at the same time. Trying to make me good and evil like you. And judge everybody, Kirk. That sends you to hell quicker than anything else on this planet. And that's called a God complex. Satan had it first.
Satan had it first.
He did something with us in Eden. That made we hated it a little bit. Mainly Adam, by the way. And you don't even want to deal with what it was.
You don't even want to deal with what it was.
You don't want to see beyond the parable Moses told you. Because he, too, is trying to theorize what he thinks happened to make us all this way.
I don't know.
You forget Moses, if he's a real historical figure, really grew up in Egypt, really did some of the things he told you in the Bible he did,
right?
And why is that? It's an example of what both to do and not to do.
Right.
But it's also the author's writing a book that is a brief introduction to him.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know Moses personally, nor do I.
Nor do I.
But I'm trying to figure out, like you, what he's trying to say to me. But he's instead of God, but he's still not a God. He's telling you that too, Jews. Right. You call it the word of God, just like the Muslims do. Just like the Christians call Christ the word of God. Mm-hmm. And just like they worship Muhammad, we worship Jesus, and you worship Moses.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But guess what? They're all men. They're all capable of failing. They're all capable of breaking the law. But only one of them rose from the dead. Though also in the role of Moses while he after he did so.
After he did so.
But unlike Moses,
right,
he taught us something different about the law. That's where you're messing up. You're so busy trying to get it right, you're getting it wrong. That's what Jesus means when he says, you think you see, but you're blind.
Mm-hmm.
You think you're here, but you're deaf.
Right.
You think you're speaking my words, but you're dumb. You're not.
You're not speaking my words.
You know not what spirit you of, as he said to the disciples when they were trying to call down fire and destroy Samaria. Because they didn't want him to come into town for some reason. Right. And just like, that's okay. Don't worry about it. Damn. But that's also why Ananias and Sapphira fell down dead at even Peter's feet when he condemned them for not getting the money. And told them they sinned against the Holy Ghost. He condemned them, not Christ. But see, they believed him when he said, they sinned.
I know.
And Satan, not the Holy Ghost, by the way, killed them by Peter's word of condemnation, right, of what they did. Their own guilt and lack of forgiveness for their mistake is also why they died. They knew they were wrong.
Right.
You understand? But I even forgive Peter
his sins.
He's lying about something, too. Simon is hiding something, too. Right, Judas? Who's Judas's father? Simon. Which Simon? There's only one Simon who is an apostle. So that one. Who is Judas Iscariot? His son?
His son. But Jesus is trying to turn the hearts of Peter and Judas back to each other. Because guess who Judas a lot, Peter? Judas. Of all the 12 to betray him. And that means none of you really wanted to betray him. You had to cast lots on who would. That kind of changes the outlook too. And Jesus even said you would deny him 3 times and you did that too.
Right.
And I know why. I know the whole story through the half story you told. Why? Because I'm paying attention like a detective of a modern day show I watch on TV. And I know there's more that you're supposed to tell because of John saying, well, Jesus did other things. But we didn't write it down in this book. But I wrote this book that you might believe that he was the Christ.
Right.
I know what that means, Peter. And whoever I am to you, like I said, my mom did see a bright light in the sky, whatever that means to you. Like a UFO. Before she had me. I don't know. And I saw the throne in heaven. And stood before it with a light before it. You tell me what that means. So I can ask you. If you read the Bible like I do, heaven is my throne. The earth is my footstool. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
These are the 2 olive trees and the 2 candlesticks standing before the God of the earth. Which is which?
Which is which?
Who is who? Who is whom? Is the light the God of heaven and earth? Or is Jesus the God of heaven and earth, though all power is given to him in heaven and earth? Is he the one that's the God? Or is he the cherub, the first created of the cherubs? And Satan is the second cherub. And again, we're not supposed to worship either cherub, but God alone. Again, right? But again, one is doing God's will as if a human being, and one ain't doing God's will as a human being. And one murdered and committed suicide of himself. And one might have been murdered by him and rose from the dead, right? Before the foundation of the world. And saying before the foundation of the world, that's in your Bible too. The tree of life and the tree of the what?
Knowledge of good and evil.
The trees are us. The sun, the moon, and the stars are them.
They're them.
Day 4, the sun, the moon, and the stars shone on the earth first.
First.
Right? Through Jesus.
Through Jesus.
Or Michael, as we call him in Revelation. Right. So Gabriel is the one who, what?
Stands in the presence of God.
Right. He told that to who?
Zechariah.
He didn't have to get all huffy with Mary. Just Zechariah.
Just Zechariah.
Hey, old man. Time for you to get a rise. In your Levi's. And have sex with your wife again. Try one more time. To knock that bitch up.
You might say it that way.
I'm teasing though. But some men are dogs, some men are pigs, some men are sheep, some men are goats, some men are dumbasses, some men are smartasses, some men are jackasses. Which are you?
Right.
That's all throughout the Bible.
I know.
Now, even Jesus got mad, though, eventually. You know they're trying to piss him off.
They're trying to piss him off.
They finally do, and he goes, nutballed into the money changers. You too. If you're trying to get him in trouble, finally did, I guess. They hold their little court. Then they bring him the pilot, and he's like, what the hell is this all about? Anyway, we're not Jewish. You're not Jewish. Right? They're having a problem with Christ. He don't even know what's going on, even with the bunny changers. And like he said, he's not getting a bad report about Christ, or he wouldn't be willing to, you know, not murder him. He called blood. It's none of his business what they believe or don't believe, whether he's their king or not. But, and they don't seem to like him anyway, and he ain't trying to do anything that we heard that we wouldn't understand. He even said, with the Caesar's of coin, render to Caesar the things of Caesar's, to God the things of God. They might like that part. Right? Right. See, our government is the U.S. Treasury. It pays our bills. And without that treasury, what? We don't have no money. We don't have no money, honey. It's all about the money, honey. Woo! That's the whole point of this. It's all about the money, honey. I didn't even have $25. I bought a $10 meal. Gave the guy $5, and that leaves me with $10. Right? Right. I know. So. But how would you know someone's not of Christ? They don't tell you the truth. They lie like Satan. Like you did. Like you did. But he told you the truth. Right. But you're what? To these men. So that they won't say it if they know it. Right. Why was it 10 days of tribulation, Peter, that John's talking about? When Jesus went up from the 40th day after Passover, and Pentecost is 50 days, that's 10 days, right? Peter, what did you do? You do, my friend. And Paul taught the 500, Peter, seeing him during the 40 days. Why was there only 120 in the upper room? What are you not telling us about that? Trust me, it's you that's now Ananias and Sapphira to me. But I'm not here to hurt you like you hurt them. You know that too. I'm here to explain why they dropped dead like you're some Old Testament prophet you wanted to be. You just scared him to death, like Jessica. That scared Jessica to death, huh? You know, you're just like that. Nope. But again, you're minding your own business. They're not minding Christ's business anymore, are they? I don't know. When John just playing along. I don't know the names of anyone but more than 12 like you, but Highlander comes to mind is why they don't know who they are anymore. They keep changing their names, right? If you're 2,000 years old, that's what it means. That's what it means. You've been lying for 2,000 years, too, faking your death, like in Highlander, right? And I know at least 500 of you, if you saw him after, he said some standing here. Even some of the Roman soldiers, if they got a little too personal, might still be here. But you're blaming still each other. No. He's blaming you for delivering your Messiah over into his hands. You're blaming him because he's a sinful man and you didn't know he would actually do that to Christ, but whatever. He's not supposed to do that. When you know the kind of man he was, or is, or one day will not be. But right now, you're all acting like morons. All right. I can't do nothing else. I can't call you nothing else. That's what you're doing. That's what you're doing. But anyway, preaching over.